It's been a phenomenal shifts in, especially in retail banking industry since the 2000s. And PSD2 and open banking is the last version of that coming to Europe. I am the retail banking manager of Isbank, a bank from Turkey. PSD2 will not be effective in Turkey by 2018, but it's still be affecting our business coming from related to Europe. And of course in Turkey we have our PSD regulation. It's the exact translation of the original PSD of EU. So I'm sure that this PSD 2 will be coming to Turkey in at most 2 years time. So we have to be ready for that. We have a chance. We are luckier than European banks because we will be able to see what they are experiencing and through EFMA, I'm sure that we'll get a lot of insights of what's on what's happening. So as I said, it's a disruptive change. That means PSD2 means that even our licensors, regulators are disrupting our community, the financial services. So this is a good sign that no one should trust the license it got from its watchdog regulator. Even the watchdog can eliminate that license and open the facilities to all the customers. And one day you may face up with thousands of competitors, not only banks. That's how we see. In the world of open banking, I see that especially account integrators will play a key role. If we lose our frontline to our customers, and if an AISB come into the picture, so that means that customer, the link between our customer and the bank is broken, and there is another player. So the strategy should be to be the account aggregator as a bank. And in theory, there is no limit to that. The regulation is leveraging the playground with the bank and the newcomers, fintech startups, whatever you name them, or any other new form of company. But the banks should take care about the account aggregators. One way or another, find a solution to get an interaction with the customer, and not to lose the interaction with the customer. That's the biggest challenge, and that's the biggest playground on my view to keep the competitive edge. I don't know if it's specific to open banking or not, but today and it seems that in the near future we'll be dealing with especially AI, artificial intelligence. That's the hot topic at the moment in our market as well. Just yesterday in Money 2020 conference in Las Vegas, we announced our collaboration with an AI firm, Clink, one of the leading ones in the world on AI. So we will develop the AI technology and customer experiences tied to this technology to our customers. That I see the AI would be the differentiating edge on the financial industry. Of course, then comes the robotics and robo-advisors, but I can definitely say that it's going to be the voice and the interaction through the voice and the AI technology supporting that would be the important factor.